What is good, gang? So today we're back again with another tutorial, and today I'm gonna be showing you guys how I made the beat for my boy 021K, which is the most notorious artist in the Persian drill scene. He has a plugin with more than 1 million views on YouTube, crazy numbers on Spotify, and in case you don't know it, I produced a track for him which is called Random. And in today's video I'm gonna be showing you the secrets that I used on that beat, and I also know that you guys are looking for the Persian drill smoke, so make yourself comfortable. Let's go over the project. Bow. So the beat itself was actually meant to be a sample drill type beat, so in the style of New York Bronx drill type of stuff, but bro, eventually he managed to get the beat and he recorded over it, so yeah, it became a Persian drill type beat. We might even call it Persian drill x sample drill type beat. Hey, started off with the sample of the instrumental by Jay-Z and Kanye West on the song Niggas in Paris. For the mixing, I cue the melody on the low end, and then here there's the notch on the high end. Then I use the compressor, and as last I use the limiter for the sidechain with the kick. I also use this automation here to automate the low end of the beat. Here at this point, I put it to the place where I wanted the low end to be at, so it goes like this, straight to the point where I wanted the low end to be at, as you can see here. So it goes like this. I then started working on the drums with this counter snare, which comes from a drum kit. As you can see, the piano roll of the counter snare, it's a pretty classic drill MIDI for the counter snare. I played around a lot with the velocity of the notes of here, and also I added some more notes underneath, as you can see here. And for the mixing, we have a pancake, an EQ on the low end. Next, I use the snare, which still comes from a drum kit. For the mixing, we have a common crusher, an EQ on the low end and the high end, and then a reverb just to give it a little bit of space on the splatter fields. And close to the end of the 8 bars, we have the secondary snare. And this one here comes from Jackie's drum kit. Here it goes directly to the same mixer channel as for the first one. And at this point, I added the kick. As you can see here, there are these notes that go one semitone below from the root note, just to give a little bit of more punchiness to the kick, because when you lower down drums, they tend to have more body. For the mixing, we literally have nothing going on except for the melody and for the 808 and for the another 808, because we have two 808s in this beat, which I'm gonna show you later on. Then I added this knob. For the mixing, as usual, you already know, guys, we have the delay, so an EQ on the low end and high end, and this time for the delay, I put it on 6 times. And at this point, I started to work on the 808, and I chose the Glock one, which still comes from a drum kit. So as you can see here, we have a note that lasts for 2 beats and another one that lasts for another 2 beats. Then we have these two slides like this. And then we have this like here, which goes from the top here and then goes straight to the bottom, so it does this interesting effect. And then we have another slide here at the beginning of the 8 bars. And then we have these 3 slides close to the end of the 8 bars. And together with what we got so far, it sounds like this. And for the mixing of the 808, we have a 3D stereo enhancer and increase the phase offset close to the right, like this. Next, we have a Maximus. This is the low end, the mid-hand, the high-end, and the master. And we have a compressor. And once I arrived to this point, it was really about adding some perks and effects to the build itself. So I added first this perk, which is called Krugel and still comes from a drum kit, which is a triangle. Then there is also this bongo. Next, there's this snare, which is more on the background. And then I also added this open hat and another one here. But yeah, overall, this is it, what I got so far. Once I got to this point with the drums, I then added all those risers, all those effects, and all that kind of stuff that you already know, guys. And this is basically the first part of the beat. So for the second part of the beat, I wanted to spice it up a little bit, so I made the jersey part and I started with this loop by Cuss Finger. And then I applied this snap from my boy J Soul. I then used this trap hi-hat. And the raised bass from a drum kit. And also used this squeak effect on the second part of the jersey part, and I chopped it and then placed it on only on the second part of every bar. For the faxes, we have the shot at the beginning of the jersey part, and then there's this riser here, and these faxes here that I also have on the drill part, so they are the same ones. I want to show you how it sounds here at the end of the 8 bars. So yeah, we have this filler, and then this riser. And as you can see here, for the first part of the jersey part, we have the same melody as for the drill part, but then it changes with this other melody. And all I did here was to use the Fruit of Love filter, and then I automated the knob like this. And as you can see here, it finishes at this point here like this. And this was more to give it a little bit of difference compared to the first jersey part, and also to make like a transition between two drops. So altogether, this is the way it sounds. For the third part of the beat, I pitched the melody up to 12 semitones and also placed the normal melody underneath without the pitch. And other than that, all I did here for the third part of the beat was to change the 808 and also to add this counter snare. So we have this one. And this one here, by the way, has the same mixing process as for the first counter snare. All I did here was to change the polarity, so I pressed the reverse, as you can see here. Here is switched off, here is switched on, but as you can see, the mixing is still the same. And this is the second 808. But as you can see here, the MIDI of the 808 is still the same as for the first 808, but all I did here was to use it another further time for the second part of the beat. I used it for 2 bars only, and then I switched it back to the first 808, as you can see here. all together, it sounds like this. For the bridge between the two drops, I just used the two melodies, this one here that I used for the drop and this other one that I used for the Jersey part, and there's also the counter snare going on, and there's this effect from my drum kit. As you can see, the beat looks pretty long, but itself is not that complicated. There aren't that many automation clips going on, and it's just elements layered each other to make the beat something more full and compact. Let's have a listen to the full beat, and make sure that you leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe to the channel, follow me on Instagram @Steppus, and bro, hey, see you till next time. Bye. Steppus on the tape.